the International Max Planck Research School for Astronomy and Astrophysics is a collaboration between our institute, the Max Planck Institute for Radio Astronomy here in Bonn, the local university, the University of Bonn, and the Cologne University, which is about 30 kilometers away from us. Our primary aim is to organize doctoral student research. We typically have students from around the world that come here at any given time, between 30 and 60 students that do research in a vast range of topics, primarily including radio astronomical observations that we do with telescopes around the world. One of such telescopes is the Effelsberg 100 meter telescope nearby. It's one of the only big science instruments that you can find in Germany where you'll be able to actually walk to an instrument of a gigantic dimension, 100 meters in diameter, and is an icon for astronomical research in the Max Planck Society and in Germany.
We are here now in Effelsberg. It's the largest telescope in Europe. And because it's so big, it has a high sensitivity, and therefore it is possible to detect faint sources with it. It is one of the telescopes I use for my experiments. Normally during observation, the scientist sits beside the operator and he has to make sure that everything goes the way it should be. If the observations are finished, everything is recorded on so-called disks. It's the same that you have normally in computers. And all these disks are then shipped towards the big computer cluster that is located in Bonn. That will in the end come to my computer where I can start analyzing it.
One of the absolutely fascinating telescopes that we use is the Sofia astral plane.
This is a Boeing a 747 which has been completely refurbished, and under this refurbishment they managed to actually install a telescope that it's very impressive to see. And on which telescope we mount instrumentation. So what we see here are actually one of these receivers with which we actually make science. It's something with which we get data, we make science. Working here, it's really the place where you can develop, I would dare to say, nowadays, the most advanced and most state-of-the-art instruments of the world for this frequency range. We are really developing cutting-edge technology.
So who are we looking for? We're looking for students who have recently finished their master's degrees, have typically some experience and some background knowledge in astronomy, but in particular, we look for motivation. We look for people who have bright ideas already and have an interest in exploring the universe. Now, what can they expect from us? We offer at this institute and the partner institutions a coherent program that is tailor-made to the needs of the researcher and that in the end will lead to excellent research and outstanding theses.
So I'm from Bogota, Colombia, and I came here because it's one of the best places to do research. It's a state-of-the-art research that they do here. It's a great opportunity.
The best thing is actually that we are that we have a lot of people from all over the world, from so many different cultures. So that's why I actually learn not only about astronomy, but also about different countries and different cultures all around the world, which is very nice.
I most like the people, of course. So it's like a really great community here, and also the supervision. They give you really good supervisors and you have a lot of like supervision, so a lot of meetings, and they really help you if you are stuck somewhere. And interacting with the other students is really nice.
Basically, we offer a deal. You come to us, you are a bright student, you are interested, highly motivated, and are interested in doing a PhD in radio astronomy. We offer you the best we can do in scientific guidance and general programmatic support. We offer you literally to see the world with peaceful means. We offer you engaging discussions, engaging scientific work, and I think in the end, a period that you will not forget in your life.